Ariel Helwani post-fight at UFC on Fox number 7 alongside Joseph Benavidez, who just finished Darren Uwe Noyama in the second round. And Joseph, I gotta say, perhaps your most dominant win in the UFC thus far. Do you agree?
Yeah, and if you're just counting the UFC, probably. I mean, I had a good knockout against Uriah Shatani, my first fight at flyweight, but we didn't get to see much else. You know, I kind of just caught him, and before that, it was just, you know, whatever. So I felt good everywhere. You know, went to the ground with a great grappler like Darren, and I felt strong. I was ready, you know, for his ground game, and you know, I think I was better, especially from top. So he's considered one of the best in the division. I felt got him there, but ended up with a knockout, which you can't argue with.
Nothing like a body shot in MMA. It's a beautiful thing to watch. First you got him with the kick, then with the punch. How'd you set that up? Explain it to us. Were you looking for that?
Yeah, definitely. I love the body shot because you know it hurts. When they wake up from a knockout, they didn't feel it, but like you feel a body shot. So it's always nice. I've been looking for a good body shot for a while. I think everyone has. But, you know, I just saw him really respecting my left kicks, and I was going high with them a lot. So I went to the liver. And once it got hurt, you know, big credit to my corner, you know, Dwayne Ludwig. I mean, we're on some kind of streak with this guy from Alpha Male, undefeated in the UFC right now. And then, you know, once I kicked him, Jimmy Gifford also in my corner, just heard them. You know, he's hurt to the body. I could kind of see it. And I definitely saw it. I know I was coming over with big right hands. So I faked the big right hand and just came to the liver with the body shot. And boy, felt awesome.
Let's not forget about the one in the first round where you almost kind of wrapped him. Like you hit him in the back there with the kick where you dropped him. Kick. Yeah, that was interesting. You kind of like, were you aiming there?
Yeah, well, yes. I mean, it's always good getting in the neck, getting in the back. And like I'm saying, man, it's just another level having a great coach like going in the corner. That was all his stuff that I was using out there. And it was just fun to finally go out there, you know, and feel it on another guy, not my teammates. So yeah, I just set him up and I actually went over his arms because he was coming out with his arms as I was punching. So I came over with the kick and yeah, fun times.
We're talking to you right now, obviously, mid-card. We just spoke to TJ. He had a big win. You pick up a win. Chad is next. Uriah had the big win last weekend. You keep mentioning Bang. I mean, it's almost like the proof is in the pudding. We are seeing what he's doing here. When he came on the team, did you expect that he would have this kind of an influence on you guys?
First of all, please refer to us tonight as Mendevita Shaw only.
Me, Chad, TJ said the same thing, by the way.
Oh, awesome. Good stuff. If we added favor, it's Bella something. Anyway,
get back to us on that.
I'll get back to you on that one. Yeah, it's crazy, man. I mean, it's amazing. You know, a lot of people ask, you know, what's the big difference? And at first it was just having a coach was the difference, like having someone that cares, that holds us all accountable, that watches video, that does this, that speaks English. That's always good too. So that was great. And then, you know, he's just gone up and over anyone's expectations. You know, he has amazing passion, you know, for the sport. And man, it's just really a blessing to have him. And I've been working with my other coach, Jimmy Gifford, on just my straight boxing. And you know, I'm just in there listening to them, you know, and a product of those guys and my fans and my family and my team, you know, and everyone that supports me. I go out and fight for them. And you know, that's what inspires me to go in there. It's just awesome.
So where do you go from here? Because now you're 2-0 since the title loss. You said after your win in February, you want to take some time. Do you still want to take some time, or do you think you should be the number one contender?
You know, I think I am the number one contender, and I was after the last fight. It was just a matter of not wanting to get back in there for a title shot so fast. You know, I made that same mistake when I was at 35s, and I fought the champ Dominic Cruz twice within 1 year. And, you know, then no matter what I did, I could go out and have dominant performances against anybody, and I wasn't going to get that title shot back. So, you know, I just thought, you know, it'd be better for the division to grow, me to grow as a fighter. You know, if I lost, I obviously don't deserve to go for the title shot, but I just felt, you know, I could get a lot better before I go out there, and that's kind of what it was last time. Of course, they give me a title shot, I'm always ready to do that as well. But, you know, especially after the last fight, that was just my thoughts. But, you know, I'm always ready for a title shot.
So do you want it next?
Sure. Like I said, I'm always ready, whatever they want to do. I mean, if you look at the division, you know, that's really the only thing that makes sense. I know Mighty Mouse has a fight already. You know, I hope he's healing up fast so he can get in there. You know, he's a great champion, and we need to get this division, you know, up and rolling again. You know, he's beat the top three guys. He has a tough guy against him. So, you know, I'd just like my shot at it again whenever it happens, whenever it seems to happen.
And how's the eye?
Oh, the eye's good. This happened 10 days ago. And, you know, it healed up good. So even when it went out there, all it took was just a slight little, like, headbutt in the clinch and open right open. But small price to pay for, you know, chiseled bone structure and this soft skin, you know, like cuts happen. It's part of the game.
Great looks as well. Yeah. Was there a chance you may have had to pull out of the fight?
No, that never crossed my mind. Honestly, it's not a real camp for me if I don't get cut. So towards the end, I was like, man, I haven't got cut yet. This is weird. And sure enough, last sparring session, got cut. Thankfully, it was about, you know, 12 days out, and I gave it time to heal, kind of.
Okay, final thing. It's a big moment. You're back on the winning track. Do you have a poem for us for this moment to celebrate?
No.
Not off the top of your head?
Out of the cage. Nothing off the top of the head. So.
Are you busy today or something?
A little busy. You know, we had to be up at 9 in the morning to get here. So, yeah, I was a little busy.
We'll give you a pass.
Yes.
Congratulations on the big win. Looking forward to the next one.
Thank you, Ariel. Appreciate it.